In this tutorial, I'll show you how to turn quad faces into tris, and apply unique material for each faces. I'll hide the meshes for now, and show you how they were modeled from scratch. Let's create a plane. Tab, to go to edit mode. Right-click and S to subdivide it 15 times like this. In edit mode, let's randomize the mesh a bit. Let's poke the faces to turn them into triangles. In object mode, Shift, D, to duplicate, and, Enter, to settle. We're adding the wireframe modifier to the duplicated mesh. That was easy, but how do we go about adding unique material for each faces? I'll show you how that gets done. We need two things to achieve that illusion. We need extrude individual and individual origins. The idea is to extrude the faces individually, and scaling them with S, while using individual origins. P to separate by selection. Let's select and remove the original plane. We're almost done, because the faces still have one shared material. I'll show you how the materials were created. I'm using this material for the wireframe mesh, but we can also use this when we're only using one material on a mesh like this. This is the random material, but the material will only show one color when the faces are not separated. I'll apply this material to the wireframe mesh. For the triangular faces, a single material like this would look good as well. I'm using EV preview, but for the environment light, we can use HDRI or Easy HDRI. But cycles won't look as good as Eevee, because we need lots of reflections on this mesh. I'll show you the material nodes in detail. Here are the full nodes for the triangular faces. Once we separate the meshes, we'll see the random colors right away. This is the wireframe meshes material. I've created this gradient material so that it can be used for the single material setting. I'll hide the wireframe mesh, and select the triangular face mesh. Tab, to go to edit mode, A, to select all, and P, to separate by loose parts. There it is. Let's type M, to put the separated meshes into a new collection. I'll increase the thickness of the wireframe. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.